So welcome to Yoga with Smiles. This is Shobha here giving you smile tips on Tuesday evenings, and Friday we have Dr. Sharda from Vrindavan Yoga, and this is me from Smile Makers Trainings. It has been a pleasure to talk to you every week on different aspects of soft skills, and what we have done, we have tried to connect soft skills with the seven energy centers, you know. So we had those seven. I will just do a quick recap. First, we spoke about the base chakra, and we spoke about security and handling your fears. Then we spoke about the second sacral chakra, that is, base was red. Then we spoke about the second chakra, that was the sacral chakra, which is basically managing your emotions. Okay, I'm giving you the soft skills topics connected with the chakras. Then we, and how you're managing your shame. The first one was managing fear. Second one was managing shame. The third one we spoke was about your navel chakra. That is about managing change and power. That was yellow color. Then we spoke about the heart chakra. Okay, where we spoke of, that was about teamwork, connecting with people, green color chakra. Then we spoke about the throat, that is communication. And that is light blue color, and this was again about, you know, the skills of, you know, connect, expressing yourself fully, throat chakra. Then we spoke about the third eye chakra. This is your bigger purpose, your bigger vision of life. Okay, so every week we have devoted a full session for each of these chakras, and we showed you how to what happens if these chakras are not balanced, how you can balance it, how you need to make little changes in your lifestyle, okay? Because every time when you have balanced chakras, and you know, then only then your life will be in balance, okay? Why am I talking about all the six chakras today? Because all these six base chakras are connected to the higher chakra, the highest chakra, the energy center which is on the crown of your head. It is called Sahasra Chakra, thousand leaf, like a thousand leaf lotus flower, okay, thousand petal lotus flower. That is the literal translation of the Sahasra Chakra, and this chakra is found on the crown of your head. Now, unlike other chakras which I can associate with different emotions and different particular soft skills topics, this is one chakra where I cannot associate with any one more. This particular energy center is a combination of all your other chakras. So all your six energy centers have to be in alignment. And when the six energy centers are in alignment, then you can talk about your aligning and finding balance in this seventh chakra. So people who express issues with their brains and their nervous systems, okay, that will happen when this energy center is not in balance. And we wonder, you know, all of us, basically we are Indians, and what we do is that, you know, one very important part of our life is prayer. Okay, so tell me, when you pray, okay, who are you praying to? We don't have any particular, some people may call it God, some people may call higher power, some people may call higher self, you know. And what exactly, we honestly, if you ask to describe who are you praying to, you may not be able to express yourself. Okay, do you really know who are you praying to? Can you just give me one word for that? Okay, can you describe it? Actually, honestly, we don't know. But one thing we all know is that we always are looking for some connection to some kind of a higher power. Correct? Yeah? So, this particular energy center, your seventh energy center, the highest energy center that you have, is the one that connects you to your higher power. Okay, after all, after going through all this, what happens in life? Man, first, as soon as he's born, a person wants security. Your khana, peena, sona, food, clothing, shelter, money, materialism, abundance. That is what we want. After that, we have certain desires and wishes. We want that to be fulfilled. After that, we want to have some power. Power over ourselves, power over our circumstances, power over the people around us. Okay? Most human beings, most of them will just live in these basic three chakras. They are called the lower energy chakras. So they live, they earn money, fulfill desires, want some power over their relationships, and then they die. Okay? But there is something more than that in life. So these are called the three lower chakras. These are called the three higher chakras. So between the two is a bridge chakra, that is your relationship chakra, your love chakra, where more than that, I feel the quality of your life is the quality of your relationships. And this particular bridge chakra, the heart chakra, is about giving and receiving love. Isn't that what we want in life? Then the next thing is we want to express ourselves, we want to express our uniqueness, we want to express our creativity, we want to leave a mark. Okay, this is something that we have expressed about ourselves. So this is that. Okay. Next, what you do want to do in life is that you want to be some kind of a contribution. You want to have some bigger purpose in life that is not only for you and your family, but it's also for the whole community. So this is all about having a vision on how you can be of contribution to people. Now, why am I talking all this? Because all this six chakras, all these things contribute to the highest energy center. Okay? Unless you develop all this, okay, you will keep working. It's not everybody who can sit and develop this seventh energy chakra. For years and years and years, we have been trying to find out what, if it is an imbalance, you will experience egoism. You will experience depression. You will experience all the kind of mental illnesses, whatever is there. Okay? And we need to keep this in balance so that when you're lifting something heavy. You try to lift it yourself, you put in some energy. But if you know that there is somebody lifting it on the other side, you know, you will probably put the same energy, but it will not seem so heavy. It will not seem so burdensome. It will seem light. So when I am talking about the seventh chakra, what is required, okay, what is required is that we are nourishing not only the body, not only the mind, but also the soul. So I want you to think of one incident in your life, or one moment in your life, where you feel that, it has touched my soul. Can you think of that? And when anything touches your soul, you stop thinking. Your mind is so active, all the time thoughts keep coming in, thoughts going out, coming in, going out. We may be aware of it, we may not be aware of it. But when there are moments in life where you feel not only your body, not only your mind, but even your soul is touched. Can you think of something? Think of something. Suddenly you go to the beach and you see the sunset and the blazing colors of the sky. Or think of a moment when your child was just born. The first time you saw your child, did you think anything else? At that moment, for 1 second, all your thoughts stopped. Isn't it? So, think about these moments, small moments, where you feel you have nourished your soul also. Okay? So, when you're working on this chakra, it is not only about nourishing your body or your mind. I've been giving you, Dr. Sharda has been giving you physical tips, I've been giving you mental fitness tips. But today is a completely different topic. It's like fitness for the soul. And there is no way I can give you much tips on that, because whatever I say may not seem so great unless you experience it yourself. Okay? So the color associated with this seventh chakra is violet. Okay? So you are trying to wear something. So try to use more of violet, try to use more of purple in your lives. Okay? Purple is a combination of all the other colors. And eat some violet colored food like brinjals and all that. Okay? But the thing is that you have to activate this chakra by looking inwards. So most of the time we are searching for something outwards. But what you need to do is actually look inwards. And one of the ways in which you can look inwards is by practicing meditation. Okay, from years and years I've been trying to do what is meditation. I swear to God, I cannot explain to you what is meditation. People say, close your eyes, take a deep inhalation, take a deep exhalation, concentrate on the power, on the space between your two eyebrows. Or people say, just concentrate on your breathing, concentrate on the tip of your nose. Some people say, concentrate on your heartbeat. Okay? There are different ways in which you can meditate. The idea is that when you are sitting and meditating, okay, you will have lots of thoughts coming in your head. But their thoughts are not coming. The thoughts are actually going out. So if there is something troubling you when you are normal, you go and you completely immerse yourself in external things. But when you are sitting quiet, when you are going inside, what is inside is actually coming out. Okay? So initially it might be very difficult for you to practice this meditation. And the idea of practicing meditation is that, can you give rest to your overactive mind? Okay? So for giving rest, first all the thoughts need to come out. And then suddenly, as you are meditating, you will come to some particular point where you feel that you are not having thoughts. You know? That itself is a thought. But suddenly you will come into a kind of a trance-like state. Okay? That is one of the ways in which you are giving rest to your brains. Okay? So, what we are going to do today, and okay, that is one thing. Okay? Meditation is one. And obviously eating all the good healthy foods, normal sattvic fruits, vegetables, that is another one. But one of the very important ways in which you can activate this third eye chakra, seventh chakra, is by practicing gratitude. Okay? So practicing journaling. So wherever you get a chance, sit and do write about what you have been through the day. Okay? Writing is a very, very, and don't show that diary to anybody. It is only for you. You don't even need to read it again. But what happens, there's something called a morning journal. As soon as you get up, you can write it early morning or you can write it before you go to sleep. But what you're doing is that you're pouring whatever's inside your head, you're pouring it out on the paper. So journaling is one of the good ways to empty your mind. Okay? Practicing meditation is one of the good ways. Another way is practicing gratitude. So what we're going to do right now, we will do that gratitude meditation where we are going to, and I told you, you never talk about the seventh one unless you talk about all six together. So we are going to, we will practice a bit of gratitude meditation, okay, saying thank you for all the different aspects of your life. Okay, that's one of the ways, and this I've been doing it for the past 20 years. I have never started my day without doing this. It hardly takes 4 or 5 minutes to do this gratitude meditation. But somehow at the end of doing it, we imagine, so I've already done this before with you all, but I'll just say a quick recap of it. We imagine there are 7 wheels, okay? Or maybe 14 wheels, okay? 7 facing front, 7 facing back. From your base, your above your base, below your navel, that place, then your navel, your heart, your throat, your between your eyebrows and your crown. There are different wheels moving front and back. And you have to imagine that, close your eyes, imagine that wheel is moving front and back, and just repeat 3 times the meditation that I say. Okay, we will repeat each meditation 3 times, but I want you to feel what I'm saying. okay, be in absolute gratitude for different aspects of your life. So we'll do the gratitude, and after the gratitude meditation, one extra thing that we do for the seven, okay, I don't do this every day, but sometimes when I feel like it, and when I can feel that extra energy in me, that's the time I do the extra meditation for the activating the crown chakra. That is, it's called a white light meditation. So first we do with all the seven colors of the rainbow. Okay, we are using that, and then we are taking a white light meditation. You have to imagine that there's a thousand pearl, thousand petal, lotus, okay, just opening up, and the petals are gone all over, and there's a white light coming in through from the crown of your head, right down, is coming from up till the tip of your toe. Did you get that? And you can feel the energy of that white light meditation. And then we are going to, and the beej mantra for this is Om. Okay, so we are going to do, why I'm talking now is that because I'm not going to talk, after I stop talking, I'm not going to say anything else. We will just be doing this quietly. So I'm giving all the instructions now only. And then we are going to say Om for 21 times. We are going to say Om. Okay, there, and we will begin with some basic yoga postures which will activate your crown chakras. So one of the very important yoga posture that can activate your crown chakra is Shirsasana. I cannot do that. Head down, leg up. So I won't even try. Okay. When you put your head down and your leg up, all the energy rushes to your brains. But unless you are practiced and unless you are under a qualified yoga teacher, please do not attempt that. Another yoga pose which we all do is, okay, when we do this Shashankasana, rabbit pose, where you sit and you put your head down, and the other one is Shavasana. So I'm going to do a bit of Shavasana also, and when we do a Shavasana, that will be, we're going to be in absolute quiet stillness. Okay, Shava means like a corpse. You're going to lie, you know, corpse doesn't think. So that's it. We're going to close with a Shavasana and saying Om. Okay, so did you get all these different ways? Now I for some time don't, okay, we are really going to go inwards, and we are really going to see what we can to do just to activate our connection to the higher power. And I'm sure you practice, make this part of your system, you practice all these small tips every day, your life is really going to be very, very, very simple. Okay? From so many years, I feel the power of the energy of a higher power next to me. But what I say and what you experience will be completely different. This cannot be same for any two persons. Everybody has a different experience with the connection with the higher power. Okay? So enjoy, activate your seventh chakra, and enjoy your own company.